you're a business owner or if you have the freedom to take free Fridays, I can feel that doors are closing and other doors are opening for no idea what that entails. But I think that's the exciting part about it. I have the freedom to literally wake up and do whatever the heck I want to do.
So I had kind of just a funny experience.
Doing a little bit of red light problem. We just woke up and going on a little morning walk to start my Friday. You guys probably know this if you follow me on Instagram, but I take Fridays as a free Friday and I kind of get to intuitively create, do what I want. If I want to work, I can work. If I don't want to work, I can frolic in a forest and do whatever the heck I want. So today is a free Friday. I started this a few weeks ago. I saw it on TikTok. Another business owner was doing it and I was like, that is such a great idea. I am going to copy her and I really wish I had her handle or knew who it was so I could tag her and you guys could watch her stuff. But if you are a business owner or if you have the freedom to take free Fridays and just intuitively create and do what you want, I highly recommend. So I'm not really sure what I'm going to do today. I think I need to go film a video for TikTok and I know I want to do that. So I'm on a walk right now at this beautiful little pathway forest by my house. Oh, by the way, I'm in Naples right now, visiting family. I honestly come here like once every 2 weeks and I love it. So I'm here for the long weekend and I am on a couple mile walk right now. And then I'm gonna go work out. And then I think I'm gonna go film a video and then beach, pool, whole thing. So I will take you guys along with me. One thing that I'm super grateful for is kind of a random thought, is that it's always nice in Florida and it's always super hot and I thrive in the heat and the humidity. So it feels so great to have places like this around my house where I can just get in nature, connect. I love listening to podcasts and I actually am listening to a podcast by this girl that I just found on Instagram. She's like a spiritual guru, if you will. And she posted an episode about one door closing and the other opening, kind of in a transitionary period. And I think I've shared this a little bit on my Instagram, but I'm kind of in this like lost period. I don't know what my identity is. I don't know what I'm doing. I think some doors are closing, others are opening, and I'm just here for the ride, but it feels good to see other people on this journey as well. So I'm kind of in this era right now of being private to myself, and not really wanting to completely share every single aspect of my life. I think for the last like 3 years, 4 years that I've been on social media, on Instagram and TikTok, and even here on YouTube. Sorry, there's a airport over here, so there's a plane that's taking off. So I think I'm in this era where I'm just kind of like more to myself. I think I have a lot of life lessons that I'm meant to learn right now, and I'm just choosing to go through that alone. It's nothing bad, it's nothing fearful, it's just I can feel that doors are closing and other doors are opening for me to blossom into this beautiful person that has manifested everything and full of abundance, and for those goals that I have in life to happen, some things need to close. So that's the beautiful process of it. And yeah, I guess I'm just sharing this to let other people know that even though that you might see my life on social media and I'm traveling and I'm running my own business and living my life how I want to live my life, there's other things behind the scenes, and I'm learning to cope with them. I'm learning to grow and heal with them. So that's the tea. That's what's going on. And I think one thing specifically is like when one area of your life feels like it's going down or in a lower vibration, not going how you want, then other areas of your life can start to be impacted by that because of your mindset. And so the most important thing that I've learned through this is just mindset. And like literally with your mindset, you can do anything. And I am a firm believer of that. And I've known this and I've known my mindset needs a little shifting in work, and so I think this is my era where it's just forcing me to grow into that and completely have faith with it. But this podcast that I was listening to, that I'll link down below, that I think a lot of you guys would resonate with too, is basically just explaining how she's in this transitionary period as well. And it's kind of in this limbo situation where you're ready for the next, but you're not necessarily intuitively called to do something, or you don't want to force it, and you just aren't really sure. And she uses the metaphor of like moving into a new house, and your new house isn't ready yet. So the new life I'm building for myself isn't ready yet, and I have no idea what that entails. But I think that's the exciting part about it, is that I am financially stable right now. I have the freedom to literally wake up and do whatever the heck I want to do, which is a very, very, which is something that I'm very, very grateful for. So just got to remember and change the mindset, and all the abundance will follow. Realizing now that I'm probably just rambling about a bunch of stuff, but it's just what was on the forefront of my mind. I'm gonna go finish my walk, and I'll see you guys when I work out, or maybe at lunch. I kind of just decided that there's stairs right here to the right, and I think I want to run some stairs. I'm feeling like I need a little bit of high intensity in my life. I was gonna go to the gym. I think I'm gonna do my cardio here, go to the gym and do like weight training, but to the stairs. Nothing insane, but there you go. Okay, I'm just sitting, chilling at a park bench. I just did some stairs, and I really only enjoy low intensity workouts. Nothing that skyrockets my heart rate, but for some reason, sometimes I just crave these high intense workouts, like running, stairs, Stairmaster. So I did like, I don't know, maybe like 7 up and downs, which it's hot in Florida, like summer is here. In South Florida, I think it's like probably like 85. It's only 9 or 10 a.m., so it's probably like 85, but the humidity and stuff, it is hot. And I love it. I'm so here for it. Also, one thing that I don't really talk about on my social media, but I played competitive sports since I was like 5 years old. So I crave like not only that sense of community, but also like that endurance and pushing yourself and competitiveness and winning. So I started with soccer, then I moved to lacrosse, and then those were like my two main sports. And then other than that, I was doing swimming and tennis and golf in the summers. I did volleyball, track, cross country in middle school, basketball, softball, you name it, I played them all. And so this reminds me of like summers, the heat, like working out outside is like the summer heat, your heart beating, sweating, just the whole thing, and I kind of love it. So I'm going to now go to the gym, maybe do like 20, 25, 30 minutes of weights. And then let's see where the day takes us. Doing a few emails before I go and film a TikTok for you guys, and then we will see where the day takes us. So I'm home right now, like I said, and I'm currently driving my mom's car, which is like literally a school bus. We have such a big family, and so we've literally always driven huge cars. I kind of like it. I learned to actually drive on an Escalade. When I first moved to Miami, I drove an Escalade, which are freaking massive. And it was literally just me. Like sometimes I'd have somebody in the front seat, but it was so funny. Anyway, I'm on my way to Walmart because if you follow me on TikTok and Instagram, I've been doing a series of finding healthy finds at kind of local grocery stores. So I did TikTok, or I did
Target, I did Costco, and you guys seem to really like them. So I'm going to Walmart Market, and Walmart Market, do not sleep on it. It is an amazing grocery store. They have so many imported fruits and vegetables. They have an organic section. They have even like Siete grain-free burritos, things like that. So that's probably like the top one, like the top three stores that my family shops at, just because the produce is so good and we eat so much produce. So I'm going to Walmart. I'm going to show you guys all the goods. By the time this YouTube video is posted, my Walmart finds will most likely be posted. So I'll link that down below. And let's get in. Just got to Walmart Market. Let's go find some healthy swaps and healthy food at mainstream grocery stores. Okay, so I'm at Walmart, and being at the grocery store is like literally my happy place. Even like all of this crap I do not promote. I just feel like at home here, you know? Not saying that like this is anything that I promote, but I'm doing a video, and so I'm going through things that I actually promote, and so just being at the grocery store is like a peaceful thing for me. So I had kind of just a funny experience at Walmart Market. I found so many goodies. Make sure you look at the TikTok below. You would be surprised at how many health foods you can find at Walmart Market. But I was looking at like the salsa aisle, and this man made a comment, and I didn't think he was talking to me because he was with his son. And so I kind of just ignored it and I kept doing what I was doing. And then he said the comment again. He said something like, it was like referring to my vitiligo. And I, usually when somebody random comes up to me and talks to me at the grocery store, I get caught off guard. And so I was kind of just like standoffish, a little bit shy. And he kept like hounding me, like, what is it? Like, what happened? And I was like, oh, it's vitiligo. It's just like a skin issue. I'm actually healing it naturally. And then I kind of went into like, I'm actually here because I built this following, or this community. I don't like saying following. I built this community on social media around just my healing journey. I'm actually here showing people that they can get healthy swaps at Walmart, blah, blah, blah. And I like went into the whole thing. And so I think it, at first I was caught off guard, but I think it's a good lesson to be learned that you can open up conversation to anybody. And then he kind of went into this oil he's been using for some of his skin issues and gave me some recommendations, and then told me that he was there getting his for his son's birthday party. I actually gave him my Instagram, YouTube, and TikTok name. So maybe he might be watching this. So if you're watching this, hi, it was so nice to meet you. And yeah, I think that like my vitiligo used to like freak me out and scare me when people noticed it and would make comments about it, especially when I was really young, like in school and middle school and stuff, and even in high school. But now I kind of use it as a conversation starter, and now this guy might follow my Instagram or my TikTok or whatever, and maybe I could potentially help him or his kids or whatever. Like, you literally never know what it could lead to. So just always have the conversation with somebody. And yeah, so I think, like I was saying, like I do get conversation starters and people questioning about my vitiligo, and I'm super open about it, super confident about it, and it's just a healing process. It's literally just white spots on my skin, and it doesn't even really matter, but I work every day to heal it. And yeah, okay, so that was my rant. Okay, so now that I am done at Walmart, I think I'm gonna go home, make a smoothie, go to the beach. This hair has not been washed in a few days. I'm sweaty, I'm hot, and I just need to go soak in the salt water. So I'm going to go to the beach, and we'll see what happens from there. Okay, I was so excited because I finally found seaweed snacks that aren't made with like canola oil or sunflower and safflower oil. And I was just in my car and I was like, oh, I'm gonna have a snack while I drive home because I haven't had breakfast yet, whatever, super hungry. I took a bite and I was like, these taste like heavy metals. Like, these taste like toxic plastic. Like, these are disgusting. I looked at the back and it was, it's been expired for a month, which isn't really that much of a concern to me. It should be, but the fact that I took a bite and it literally tasted like heavy metals, like, I have a disgusting taste in my mouth right now. I really wish I bought a drink, but I just went back in there to return it, not for the money, but just to be like, hey, take this off your shelf. And also, it's expired, but also they taste really toxic, and you should just not, I do not promote putting any of that in anyone's body. So this is your sign to always be aware. It, even if the ingredients are great, it's the packaging that also is a little bit of a concern.
Going to the beach. I just made a little bit of avocado toast before I head to the beach. I get questions about what avocado or what toast I use, and I use the Food for Life gluten-free English muffins. They're like brown rice, they're super good. And with the Siete hot sauce, it is a total game changer. So super yummy late breakfast, and then I'm gonna go head to the beach for some sun. I just ate my breakfast. I have been listening to Devin Levesque, I think is how you say his name. He's friends with Jesse Itzler, and I in the last week have been into all of their content, podcasts, YouTube, all of it. And I just think that the life they live is super extraordinary and fulfilling and something that I strive towards. And so I've just been diving into all of their work, kind of where they got to where they are. So I've been listening. I just listened to a live with him, and I feel after you kind of hear these life lessons from somebody who's gone through things like that and like is where they are, it's super, it's super motivating. So I highly recommend you guys check Devin and Jesse Itzler out. I just took the golf cart to the beach. You guys can see it's still like destroyed from the hurricane, and it's so sad because this used to be like so beautiful with palm trees and stuff, but it is a glorious afternoon, so we're going to chill, maybe read, journal, swim, and the water looks amazing. I actually decided that I am going to edit some of the content that I got today at Walmart. When I say, I know I mentioned free Fridays, like this a lot, some Fridays I don't work at all, some Fridays I just intuitively choose what I want to do, and I also don't look at content as like a job. I don't really look at my job as a job at all, in any way, so I'm just going to edit, chill, do some work. It's so nice. I've been trying to shield my face just because it's literally so hot in South Florida right now. But yeah, I'm just gonna enjoy my time here, do some work, and then swim. Beach smoothies hit so different. This is passion fruit, banana, mango, coconut water, and raw honey. We're going to pick up some dinner, and I can't show you guys what I'm eating. Okay.
Heavy.
Oh, whoa.
Friday night.
Whoa, that's a big one.
Hell yeah. That's
can we one. Take it?
No.
Is it empty?
We want it. Give it to us. If you guys haven't used a salad spinner, this is life-changing. Once you wash your lettuce, using this is helpful to keep it, get the water off and crunchy. And also, if you have lettuce that you rinsed and you want to keep it crunchy, just putting it in here and putting this whole thing in your fridge really helps to keep it. So I'm currently making dinner for my sister and I just have a salad going here. I made some rice and we're marinating some local grouper right now and putting it on the grill, and we're just gonna have like salad rice grouper situation, and I'm excited. Just her bitch. On a mission, on a damn mission.
Little
going out tonight, and I am going to meet up with some of my family that's in town also. And of course, I'm having tea before. I'm doing my red light therapy before. If you follow me on Instagram and TikTok, I always post about red light therapy. I mostly have a red light therapy face mask that you guys have probably seen me do, and I've showed it in a bunch of my other videos. But now that I'm home, we have this like full body, like rectangular red light square thing. And I like it because I could just set it up, and I like it because I can get my full body. I like to do it when I'm on my period for like reproductive and women's health and hormones. I've been having some other health issues with like skin and muscle, and I've noticed that the red light really, really helps. I like this red light specifically because it has no EMF exposure radiation, and my whole family uses it. My dad had knee surgery about like 9 months ago, and he's had complications with his knee. He'll sit in front of this for like 30, 45 minutes while he's reading, doing his emails or whatever, and he's said that the inflammation and noticed that it has helped him a lot. My aunt has seen really good benefits with her red light also, with tennis elbow and just muscle soreness from working out and playing tennis and pickleball and stuff. I could go on and on, but my family is like huge red light stands. And I literally texted my mom today and I was like, hey, do you mind if I bring this back to Miami with me? Because I'm just that obsessed with it. So I'm doing a little bit of red light probably like 20 minutes before. I have some ginger tea, and then I'm going to get ready and I'll bring you guys out with me. Do it for the Hewitts, damn it! We just woke up and we are going to a local juice and smoothie shop to get some juices and smoothies before we go on the boat for the day. If you're in Naples, you probably know Food and Thought, and it's an organic grocer, clothing store, juice shop. So we're going to get some juices and spend the day in the sun. My cash in either of these drawers. It is such a nice day, guys. It's like probably 85, kind of humid and hot, but I'm so excited to just be on the water, bask in the sun, and hang out.